The Philippine Stock Exchange's former trading floor has been revamped into an events venue following its closure last year. Jackie Pascual has the story.
It was June last year when the Philippine Stock Exchange's trading floor shut down for good, marking the PSE's transition to 100% digital trading amid the pandemic. Almost a year later, the floor has been transformed into the new PSE Events Hall. Traders' desks have been removed, the floor and walls have changed, and the huge screen hanging in the middle of the floor has been replaced. What remains are the stock ticker screens. And there's a new large market data board.
Since this events hall will be the venue for IPO, FOO, and SRO listing ceremonies, we are one in our desire to see the local capital market catch up with its peers in the region. We all understand the urgent need for new products and proactive regulations to improve liquidity in the stock market.
Top government officials attended the inauguration of the new events venue and said this is a good move for the local bourse.
This hall represents what could be in the future. An economy where capital markets are more developed, an economy where funding of big projects and activities could be funded by thousands of, hopefully even millions of people.
The opening of this listing ceremonies venue and the unveiling of the market data board signify our shared objective of promoting transparency, growth, and development of the capital markets.
We are counting on you to be a strong engine in the development of our capital markets by powering the Philippine equities market with advanced technologies, widely accessible market information, transparency, and robust risk management.
2, 1.
Ayala Corporation officials also joined the event to mark a successful share sale.
Ayala is delighted to be listing its 3.1 billion preferred shares issue right here, right now, will support our company's many growth initiatives. These initiatives are testimony to the Philippines' renewed growth.
The PSE needs a boost. Its average daily trading value went down by 5.5% year-on-year in the first quarter of 2023. This measure is generally seen as an indicator of market activity and investor interest. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
A Philippine senator urges the Energy Regulatory Commission to explain why it allowed the state grid operator to collect fees for pending and unfinished transmission line projects. Senator Francis Escudero says, aside from demanding a refund from the consumers, it is just right for them to know the motive behind ARC's actions.
Dalang pwedeng gumawa ng solusyon dito, ERC din. At nangyari ito dahil pinayagan ng ERC. So magandang tanungin, bakit pinayagan ng ERC na maningil ang NGCP sa mga proyektong hindi pa naman tapos at pinapakinabangan ng mga consumer?
The owners of MT Princess Empress insist the sunken tanker that caused a massive oil spill in the Philippines is not an old vessel. They also told lawmakers they've already given aid to the affected communities. Vivian Gulia with this report.
Please raise your right hand. Officials of RDC Real Marine Services, the company that owns the sunken MT Princess Empress, issued an apology on Monday as they faced a joint house panel investigating the massive oil spill from the incident.
We sincerely apologize to the communities, the local and national government and agencies. Elements beyond human control, such as sudden weather disturbance in the area, resulted in this unfortunate event.
But the company asserted the sunken oil tanker was not an old vessel, contrary to the Justice Department's opinion issued during the previous House committee hearing.
Newly constructed po yan. Maipapatunay ko po lahat ng mga steel plates at documents kung ano man po. I mean, may bibigay ko po rito. Before the next hearing po, isasubmit ko po.
RDC Re-Yield Marine Services says it sent food packs to affected residents and is expecting $1 billion insurance coverage for oil pollution protection and indemnity.
How much premium did you pay?
Around $20,000 to $22,000.
Okay. You present within 5 days a copy of that insurance and a copy of that receipt of $20,000 to $22,000. Otherwise, okay, I will move for your contempt.
Over 41,000 families felt the brunt of the massive oil spill, according to DSWD records. And the agency's assistance has exceeded 611 million pesos, which include food and non-food items, emergency cash transfers, assistance for individuals in crisis situations, and cash for work. But for one LGU and a lawmaker, these are not enough.
Hindi sapat at delayed ang natatanggap na ayuda. Until now, wala po talagang hanap buhay yung ating mga fisher folks. Sana makasuhan na po. For 3 months, wala pa rin pong nangyayari.
The oil spill also caused destruction to coral reefs in the area, estimated at 9.4 billion pesos, and mangroves estimated at 120.5 million pesos. Another lawmaker expressed concern over a supposed waiver affected residents are asked to sign.
Bibigyan daw sila ng 15K one time at hindi na sila pwedeng magdemanda pa later on pag nabigyan. So gusto ko lang ma-confirm ito.
Wala po akong alam sa waiver na yan.
Three more areas lifted fishing ban according to the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. These are Calapan, Bansud, and Gloria. The Philippine Coast Guard, meanwhile, remains optimistic it can beat the four-month deadline for the oil spill cleanup. With a Monrovian-registered dynamic support vessel Fire Opal arriving in Oriental Mindoro, the Philippine Coast Guard says the siphoning of the remaining oil at the sunken tanker has already started. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine House of Representatives passes on third and final reading a bill declaring the country's maritime zones. These comprise of internal and archipelagic waters, territorial sea, continental shelf, and contiguous and exclusive economic zone. Lawmaker Rachel Arena said the measure will be beneficial in the country's pursuit of food and economic security, as well as promoting the Philippines' territorial integrity. The House will submit the bill to the Senate for action. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines advises commercial pilots to avoid the airspace surrounding North Korea, South Korea, and Eastern Japan due to the planned satellite launch of Pyongyang. CAAP said in its notice to airmen that pilots should implement all safety precautions and refrain from entering the affected airspace from 8 a.m. on May 31st until 7:59 a.m. on June 11th. North Korea state media on Tuesday confirmed the country will launch a reconnaissance satellite in June. The move, according to a senior defense official, is aimed at monitoring military movements of the U.S. and its allies.